just branding.
Today we have Washington, D.C.'s own Mr. I Sang with Brandy. What about you? Ladies and gentlemen, we present Mr. Ernest Gaston.
Hi, everyone. What's going on out there?
Just Brandy just embarked on this relaunch and for the Star Shines moment. And we wanted to just thank you for taking the time out to talk to us and to all the other fellow stars out there. And just to kind of begin, we want to just ask, who are you and where you're from and a little bit about who Ernest is?
Well, Ernest is a D.C. native. I was born and raised in Washington, D.C. I currently attend Howard University. I'm a student. I'm still undecided. So I don't have a major yet, but I feel what I want to go through. I also work at Howard University as well. So, you know, with that being said, I know a lot of details that a lot of students don't know. I can't get them out though. But it's all good and it's all love at the end of the day. I'm just a fun going out person. I love to go out. You know, I do the regular bowling, movies, music, of course. The number one person on my list will be Brandy, of course. Every album, mostly every unreleased single. You know, so that's who Ernest is. I'm just a young man trying to make it in the so-called world that we live in.
Absolutely. The topic at hand. Tell us, why do you love Brandy Rihanna Norwood, soon to be Miss Press?
You know what? I get that question asked a lot, and I really do not know how to answer this. I've been liking Brandy ever since I was 5 or 6 years old. So, by that being said, I didn't know what music actually was. I mean, I knew what it was, but I didn't understand it. You know, so I'm listening to on the radio, I'm watching videos, and I just see this girl with braids, and I'm like, wow, you know, she's really different, and she has a unique voice. And I'm like, who is this girl? And they said, Brandy. And I'm like, wow, because to be honest, I used to be stuck on Whitney Houston at that age as well. Brandy just does something to me that no other artist could have done. Her voice speaks volumes to me. It's her inspiration. It's her words. How she comes across in her music. It's everything about her. You know, she's definitely an inspiration. She's definitely my hero. I've just been through a lot. She's gotten me through a lot with her music. And ever since then, I became a fan. Ever since I was 5 or 6 years old, and it has not yet stopped. You know, a lot of people call me crazy, but I think it's a good crazy because, hello, it's Brandy. And people have to understand that they don't understand what Brandy actually does. I know I'm rambling right now.
No, go ahead.
It's just something that us fans know, you know, when it comes to our favorite. You know, if people want to sleep on her, don't sleep. Don't sleep. Because remember, Brandy was the first to do it all. Brandy was the absolute number one back in the 90s and 2000s as well. So a lot of people want to shade her and do all this other BS. I don't know if we can curse or not. But
you can if you feel the need.
Okay, well, that's good to know. but, you know, she just perfected to me. And I feel like I'm a part of her family. I feel like I know her. She's just so special to me. She really is. I don't know what it is, but it's just something about her voice, her energy, her positivity and life. She really taught me that anything is possible. Just go out for your dreams and you can be anything you want to be.
Absolutely. So, what is your favorite Brandy song and why?
Oh, my God. Oh, and why? Oh, he is. I can answer that quickly if you can't hurry. I don't know why he is my favorite song. Because if you really think about it, you know, she's singing to a man and whatnot, and he is. But Warren Campbell did the shit what he did because he wrote He Is. And I don't know what it is that Brandy sung it the way that just made me feel the lyrics, made me feel the message of the song. And, you know, I switched it up when I was younger. You know, I used to say, you know, she is and all that other stuff, but clearly, you know, that has changed. But it's just he is. I mean, I don't know. It's just the melody, the way she sings it. It's this raw talent. And, yeah, he is my favorite song. He is. It's my all-time favorite Brandy song.
All right. So what is your favorite Brandy album and why?
Oh, 2011. 2011. 2011 is my favorite Brandy album because, you know, first of all, this is her sixth album. And I can finally understand, by me being an adult, where she was coming from. I love the evolution. I love the voice of the album. I love the maturity. I love the sexiness. This is Brandy's finally, you know, Brandy's confident album that she has never did before. So that's why I love it so much, because she's giving us raw talent that Brandy has never even sung about, never talked about before. So when I got that album on October, well, I got it before a lot of people. There's a video on that on YouTube. But when I heard it, I was like, I fell in love with it. And I'm like, oh my God, this beat Full Moon. And I'm like, how can this album beat Full Moon? But it definitely did. A lot of people may think other, but in my opinion, 2011 is the best Brandy album until the 7th, of course, gets here.
Absolutely. So what is your favorite track off of 2011?
Oh, wow. That's funny. You actually asked me that today through a Facebook group chat. And I have so many favorites that I just can't pick one. But this week, I would say Slower. Slower is my favorite Brandy track. It's so sexy. It's so smooth. It's the runs. It's the voice. I mean, Brandy must have took a lot of time doing that record for her to even say it's too hard to fucking sing, you know, live. I love Slower. That song is just everything to me right now. Then, of course, Hank This House is definitely come second. Had to throw that one in there.
Oh, wow. Okay. Seeing that 2011 is the current album out right now, what would you say were some of the highs and lows from this era?
The highs were, you know, her coming back. You know, that was definitely high for me because, like Randy said, she thought it was old for her. But, of course, I never thought that. I just thought, you know, Brandy's taking another 4-year hiatus, you know, get her stuff back together to get where she was going, which she did. She came back, delivered a masterpiece album, went on tour, finally, you know, did a lot of things with the fans and corporation. But the lows were, to me, I just think it was the promotion-wise, you know. Even though we only got 2 videos, I really think the team or the label could have sent out a lot of more promo singles to support the album. So we just didn't get put it down a lot of streams. You know, I really think they could have really delivered more with that project. It don't have to be a video all the time, but, you know, just promote the album. Just promote the album. Give radio some singles and play it with and see how the people react to it. And maybe that could have been a possible single. You know, and the also low is that we were getting a 3rd single, but we don't know what happened with that. You know, do you know what was supposed to be the 3rd single, but unfortunately something went in, something happened, I don't know what happened, but it was sad on the fans' part, because here we go again, waiting another 4 years, and we only get 2 singles. And it's a blower sometimes. Mm-hmm. Well, really 3 videos, if you want to count, it all belongs to me, but we know what that leads to, and I'm not even trying to go back down that road.
Okay. What is it about Brandy that you love so much and so adamant about seeing her win?
I mean, I would see Brandy every chance that I get, you know, if I have the money for funds, right, of course. It's just, I just love seeing her, because I don't know what to expect from her when I see her live. You know, maybe she'll, you know, perform and do a new song, and I was there to witness that. Like on Saturday, I had no clue that she will put the mic in my mouth. And for one reason, I can't sing worth a shit, but I wasn't shy. I wasn't anything. She gave me that mic, and I just started blowing. You know what? I think I found better than Monica. You know what? I mean, hey, don't sleep. But no, okay. I'm kidding. You know, don't sleep. But I'm kidding. But it's just everything about her. I love seeing her. I love seeing her smile. I love seeing Brandy in a happy place. And I would love to witness that every time.
So you said that you've seen Brandy live a lot. And, of course, her live experience is experience all into itself. What was your favorite live experience?
Oh, wow. There's so many experiences. I can count Saturday as one, definitely. But my real live experience would say when she came to DC the first time, well, not the first time, but she was promoting the album at the WKYS R&B Live conference, mm-hmm. where she performed a number of songs, and I got to go backstage. She gave me a shout out on stage, and you know, just seeing her, we taking a picture and everything. But the number one thing was when 2:11 was released in New York City. You know, we were all there. You know, I met a lot of stars. People travel all over the world. You know, just to be there and just having that experience that Brandy is finally back. And she's finally doing what she loves to do. And seeing her on that stage, because I haven't seen Brandy on stage at a real concert since the Never Say Never Tour, which was June 26, 1999. On a Saturday, the show started at 7:30 prompt.
Wow.
And just seeing her there, I'm like, oh my God, look at my big sister. And she looked so good and looked so sexy, and she was just in this place I'd never seen her before. And I got a chance to go backstage and chill with her and just see the experience of what someone goes to a concert after it's over. And that's a memory that I would never forget. You know, just that whole week, we got to chill with her backstage at Wilmington Park. I mean, that's something that would go down in history for me that I would never forget. So I would definitely have to do the New York show, which was October 15th. 2012. You were there. You know I was.
Absolutely. Right.
It
there.
It was a great experience.
Yes. You recently got to sing The Boy Is Mine with Brandy during a live concert. Can you tell us more about that experience?
Oh my God. It just happened out of nowhere. But I'll give you my point of view on it. Brandy always asks the audience to sing Monica's part. And because you know Monica's not there. And that's cool. We don't need Monica everywhere. But the way, it was a video posted at the Essence Festival where she told the audience to sing Monica's part. And this look that she gave her face was just hilarious. And like, it's like, they wasn't even singing. I'm like, come on, The Boy Is Mine is a classic. Everyone should know the words.
Right.
So when she looked at me and she saw me singing along with her, I'm like, oh my God, she coming to me right now? Thinking in the back of my mind, no, she's not. It's not about to happen. She put the mic in my phone, and I just started blowing. You know, like I said earlier, I'm not a vocalist, but at that time, a job had to be done, and I did it.
Exactly.
You know, you don't say no to Brandy in that type of circumstance.
No, you don't.
You know, you just sing whatever comes out your damn mouth. I should have gone slower, though, but I don't want to mess up the groove.
Wow. Yeah, don't mess up the groove.
No, don't mess up the groove.
Brandy is you are silly. Brandy is known for her vocal prowess, but she's also a renowned actress. What is your favorite actor role by Brandy?
Oh, I still know she did last summer. And I say this because that was the first time Brandy was cursing. Brandy was, you know, making out, you know, in the hot tub, and I'm like, oh wow, this is not Moesha that we're seeing right now. You know, this is, you know, a mature, growing up Brandy. And I'm like, wow. And this girl is kicking ass. And I'm glad she did not die in the movie. Because, of course, if you die in the movie, the black person always go first.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I mean? So, seeing her in that type of horror action flick, I would love to see more of that. And it wasn't a singing role, unlike some other artists. I won't say no names. But it was just great to see finally Brandy step out her comfort zone and do something so different. And, you know, it was just lovely to see that movie. You know, she was only 19 at the time. I was like, what, 12 or 13? So it was great. It was great. So that's my favorite movie by Brandy is I Still Know What You Did Last Summer.
Cool. What was your first real introduction to Brandy Norwood?
My first real introduction, I would definitely say when she came to the Walmart for the Never Say Never Tour. She was signing autographs and everything. I mean, the line was so long, and I really thought I was not going to get up there a chance to, like, really meet her and see her because, you know, the line was so long. She had a show that night. But luckily, you know, it was just that moment that I shared with her. Of course, she doesn't remember because that was so, like, long ago and everything. But just being there, Miss Sonya Noah was not playing. She said, shake hands only, please. No pictures, no hugging. You know, there's nobody in play back then.
Okay.
But I still wanted a hug. But at that time, I thought, you know, Miss Sonya was going to look at me and probably, you know, give me the raise of the hand to get the hell out of here or something. But, you know, but she did. So I just took Brady's hand. And basically, I was just shocked. I was speechless the whole time. And then going that night to the Never Say Never Tour, I was speechless. I mean, I didn't do anything. I was just staring at her.
the whole damn time of the whole concert, and I'm thinking to myself, oh my God, she's real. Brady's real. And I'm like, my whole life I wanted to see her, and there she is, right in front of my eyes. And I just couldn't grasp it. I didn't understand it, but now I do. You know, so that was the very first time she really exposed me, when I finally met her. Well, not really meet her, but, you know, just shook her hand and everything. But you get what I'm saying.
So, how has Brandy influenced your life?
Well, I'm not a singer, so, you know, but I try to sing, and I can do her runs in the shower and everything. And everyone knows they sound good when they got earphones and you sing it to yourself and you act all like, you know, you're the king of the world. No one's stopping you, but when other people give you that look, and they know you sound in that mess, but they won't say nothing, they'll just smile at you. But, you know, she's definitely influenced me in my writing and, you know, acting as well. I lost a passion for acting, but, you know, I write a lot of plays now for the youth. So she definitely does play a part in that, because I try to incorporate, you know, some Brandy motives in my productions and whatnot. So she definitely has allowed me into writing and getting back to the acting field.
Cool. Brandy is known for her brandoms, and what is your favorite brandom and why?
My favorite brandom is, she typed this about years ago. It was like, you know, don't let haters stop you, or something like that. But I have to research. She tweeted like 2 years ago, and I'm like, because I know we all know that Brandy's been through a lot, and you know, when she does her brandom, you know, it's always a reason why she think of something at that moment. So I felt like, Brandy, you better let them know that you are here to stay, that you know what you want to do, you know who you are as an artist, and don't let nobody rain on your parade. And that's what I had to, you know, realize, because people are always going to, you know, complain about your work. It's not good enough. You could have done better. It's always that negative vibe that people always try to reach in your ear, but you just have to ignore it. So it was one of them type of brandoms.
Cool. In your own words, how has Brandy influenced the music industry?
Brandy has definitely influenced the music industry just by what she accomplished to me, what she accomplished. You don't have to sell a lot of records, you know, to be known for. But Brandy sold over 30 million records, so she's good. You know what I mean? So all these terms they came out when I was flop and, you know, time has passed, that's bullshit to me. Because you know what, she's still relevant, she's still here today, and as long as you keep your mouth open talking about her, obviously you feel some type of way about her. So obviously you somewhat do care what she has to prove or what she has done. And to me, that's what in all reality that's what it is. You know, you by you talking about her, you're keeping her relevant, you know, you're commenting on her Facebook statuses, you're retweeting for tweets in good or bad, you know, just to let people know that you have nothing to worry about. You know, I mean, she inspires so many young artists today. You know, she gets so many tweets from celebrities, and I don't understand what's wrong with the generation that they can't accept it. They always gotta put, you know, negativity into everything that what happens to Brandy. And I'm like, and so I always say, why don't people like Brandy? Like, I never get that. I never understood that statement. What don't you like about her? How can you not like Brandy? How can you not like her? Give me a reason why. Give me a reason why. You know what? No one ever gave me a reason. I just don't like her. I like Monica better. I like Beyonce better. I'm like, okay, cool. Why don't you like Brandy? No way.
No.
You know what I mean? It's like, if you're going to say something, make sure you explain it. Because anything Brandy, anything your artist can do, Brandy can do much better, and she has, and she was the first. You know, come with the receipt, okay? Come with the receipt, and we'll talk later.
Right. Brandy has accomplished a lot in her career. What would you like to see her do that you've never seen her do before?
Well, she's acted, she's sung, she modeled a folk person. I would love to see Brandy do Broadway. I would love to see Brandy do Broadway. That would be interesting to see. I have her in this old type of, you know, feel, like Lady Sings the Blues, that type of part. And I just love to hear Brandy's voice. So I would love to see Brandy do something like that on Broadway, like Lady Sings the Blues or something like that. But she got to be the main character, of course.
Wow. I never would have thought that one. That's a nice one. When you think of what the Starz are, what would be your definition?
Starz are people who love her, people who support her, people who lift her up, people who give her positive feedback, people who, like I said, people who support her. You know, I know as fans, we all don't agree, you know, but at the end of the day, we're here for one person, and that's her. And that's what we all can agree on.
Right.
That's what I feel what Starz are. We're real and we're genuine.
Absolutely. If you had Brandy in front of you right now, what is it that you would want to either ask her or say to her?
Can I answer both?
You can answer both.
Sure. The question I want to, you know, ask her definitely is, would you ever write your own full album? Your own full album? And how long does you have to wait for another album to come out? You know, hopefully we're hoping for 2014. You know, that's what I'm hoping for. I'm pushing it, but it don't have to be her own writing. I'm just pushing for 2014 that we get another brand new record, because I think it's about that time. And I'm sorry, what was the other question?
What would you want to say to her?
I already said it. You know, I told Brandy, I love you, and you saved my life, and, you know, it is her music. I just want to chill with Brandy again for that one-on-one time for at least by myself for at least 20 minutes. That's all I really need is 5 minutes with Brandy by myself. And I swear to God, I can get 20 questions out there in 5 minutes. You know what I mean? I'm not going to belay the faster. Because I know what the fans want to hear. Because trust me, I want to hear the same thing. You know, but I expressed how I felt, you know, to her when I was in Atlanta last month. And she was like, she knows. And, you know, she knows who I am. You know, you're a great supporter. You know, I love my fans for that. I love you for that. So Brandy knows how I feel. But I really never really got to, like, sit down, you know, with her, you know, in a quiet place where, you know, no one is around and one's pushing you to really, really talk to her. And it's always this person in that ear, that person in that ear. I really, really want to sit down and really have at least, you know, just 5 minutes, like I said, just 5 minutes to really talk to her and really express to her so she can really hear it with all the noise and the music in the background and people talking in the background so she can actually believe it. So I can give her my damn number and all that other good stuff.
Right. If you could make your own brandom for the world to hear, what would it be?
That's a good question. If I could make my own brandom, what would it be? It would be something, you know, very, very simple. To me, it would be something, I don't want to talk cliche or anything, but closed mouths don't get fed. We'll put it like that. Closed mouths don't get fed.
You want to expound on that?
Well, I will explain it. You know, we don't know what this world has in store for us, you know, in our future. Hopefully, everyone, we want, you know, success and everything. But if you don't open your mouth and tell people what you really want, you won't get it. So it's sometimes, you know, it's not what about what you know, but it's about who you know. You know, and plenty, a lot of artists have got away with that because I see a lot of artists who don't have no damn talent but selling millions of records. I won't say no names.
You are a mess. You are. What is your favorite Brandy video?
Oh, What About Us? Hands down, What About Us is my favorite video because it was so different, it was so sexy, it was so futuristic, and I've never seen Brandy like that in my life. That was a great comeback video. I still remember making up the video when Dave Myers, and it was just great. What About Us is my favorite Brandy video of all time. What About Us?
What is your favorite unreleased song by Brandy?
Oh, wow. Fool by the Moon. Fool by the Moon. I really wish that was on Never Say Never, because clearly that's when she recorded it. But Fool by the Moon is my all-time favorite unreleased record.
All right. We asked everyone to sing a little bit of your favorite Brandy song.
Oh, my God. Are you serious? Already,
you've already sung with her. Could you just bless us with your vocal prowess?
Oh, wow, y'all put me on a spot like that? You know, Brandy was different. I mean, when Brandy gave you a mic, you just singing to it. But now you're singing on the phone? Oh, wow. I'm not a singer. Don't laugh, okay?
Okay, I won't laugh.
I have a cold right now, so, you know.
Oh, God, that's what singers say.
I'm not going to do slower, but, okay. Prince Charming, my angel, my king, and my friend. That was your gift for now. That was your gift for now. I don't have no tea or no water with me right now.
Oh, okay. All right, so you're a very opinionated and vocal person.
Oh, yeah.
I want you to take this moment and now talk to Brandy's team. Go.
Talk to Brandy's team. Hello, Brandy's team. You guys, you know, have done a great job on, you know, at the very beginning. You've done a great job, you know, with the performances, you know, and whatnot during the album release week. But I would like for you guys to come next era to be well prepared. Meaning, you know, we don't want to wait. We don't want to have a single out in April and the video comes out in late August. We want more television, you know, television performance, late night performance like Ellen, Queen Latifah show, since that's new, Arsenio Hall, since that's new. We want everything. We want SNL. We want everything that the other artists get that Brandy didn't get. Because honestly, we're at work during the day and people can't see what's really going on unless you go on YouTube, which is not the same because YouTube don't get ratings, you know. So we want everything possible. I mean, I want the Grammys. I want the MTV Video Music Awards. I want the MTV Movie Awards. I want the BET Awards. Singing her old songs, no covers. You know, I want Soul Train. I mean, since Brandy is a vocal singer, hello, you think she will be there? I want everything. And I know it's hard work, and I know it's a lot into it. Going into that, I don't understand. I don't understand it, but you know where I'm coming from. We want Brandy everywhere. We want to see her on TV, back on the big screen. Albums, you know, not an album, we want albums. We want DVD, we want concerts, major concerts. You know, not no spot dates, but she's here 1 month. Oh, then Brandy's there the next month. No, I want day after day after day. I want her to go on a major tour. You know, give me something like, you know, the Conference Hall, Verizon Center. Yeah, I get another guest. Yeah, I can even perform together. You know, Trey Songz and Brandy tour doesn't sound bad at all. You know, because after what I seen on Tuesday, they make good chemistry. You know, bring Miguel. Bring somebody. We just want the best for Brandy. We want to see her everywhere. Okay, because a lot of people didn't know 2:11 was even out. So, Brandy team, I got much love for y'all. I know y'all work very hard. But if you want to give it, you got to give it. That's all.
Well, then, I guess you said it all. Oh, okay, for all the stars out there, tell us how we can find Ernest, whether it be website, social media sites, email, Vine, Instagram, etc.
Sure. You can reach me on Twitter at Ernest Gaston, E-R-N-E-S-T. Last name Gaston, G-A-S-T-O-N. It's going to be Ernest Stephon Gaston. You can follow me on Twitter at Forever Ernest. That's the number 4, Ever Ernest. Also the same with Instagram at Forever Ernest. And yeah, that's it. That's it. Yeah, Twitter, Facebook, and Instagram. So yeah, those are my contacts and everything. So you stars, come support.
Wonderful. Well, Ernest, I want to just thank you for talking with us, and I want to give you the final word. So if the floor is yours to give us our final goodbye.
Well, I appreciate this. I really do. It was great having this interview. I hope I wasn't too ratchet or anything, but when I get the Brandy telling, you know, it just takes over. You know, it takes over because stuff needs to be heard, and I know a lot of people won't say it, but you talk to me anytime, I'll let you know. I'm just here for Brandy, of course. That's all who I'm here for. I love her. I want the very best for her. We support her. And I just hope that people, you know, will gravitate towards her as well. And let it be known that Brandy is here to stay. She's not going anywhere. She just celebrated 20 years. I'm looking for 20 to 40 years more in the game. So thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you so, so much. And I guess that's about it. Yeah, I love you, Brandy.
Thank you, Ernest.
You're very welcome.
Right.
Just Brandy.